Hi guys, welcome back to Lunatic Astrology. I'm your astrologer, Lori Lothian. Today, we're going to talk about Jupiter and Pluto. They're coming together in the sky, and they're going to do some really cool stuff. Basically, they're going to try to come together and create this wealth yoga for the third time this year. Now, Jupiter and Pluto came together April the 4th, June the 30th, and they're coming together November the 12th. And for each of us, depending on our rising sign or sun sign, and even moon sign, it's going to bring some abundance, some prosperity, some goodness, some hope, some optimism, something good, even power to the place in the chart where this particular combination of planets falls, which is around 23 degrees of Capricorn. It's 22 degrees and 51 minutes. So really rounded up, 23 degrees of Capricorn. And if you have any planets in Capricorn within 3 degrees of 23 degrees, so 20 degrees of Capricorn to 26 degrees of Capricorn, you're really going to feel this quite strongly. And as well, anybody who has any planets at the near the 23rd degree of the cardinal signs are the sign Aries and Libra and Cancer and Capricorn. You're really going to get a nice big reverb from this wealth yoga. Let me talk a bit about, before I go into all signs, why this is a wealth yoga. What makes Pluto and Jupiter about wealth? Because that's not all they're about. But one of the reasons is that Jupiter is about things that are under the earth, right? What's under the earth? You know, gems, gemstones, rubies, diamonds, gold, oil, precious metals, seeds that germinate. And so in the ancient world, the underworld god himself was associated with these things that had to do with bounty and with wealth. And as well, think about the words like plutocrat. You know, that comes from the word Pluto, that means power. You can see that there was an association with wealth and power that went with Pluto. He wasn't just some guy stuck in the underworld, you know, moping along with the dead. And the underworld was a very rich place with very many dimensions, right? The Elysian fields, and it wasn't just one place and one thing, but that's another story. And how he got to be god of the underworld was that he drew straws. Zeus, king of Mount Olympus, the one who overthrew the Titans in a war, youngest brother of Neptune and Pluto, held out behind his back to, I think it was a sapphire and a black stone, and the brothers chose, and the black stone was the winning of the underworld, which Pluto got, and the sapphire, the blue sapphire, was Neptune's or Poseidon's winning of the being god of the seas. So that's how they got their kingdoms. Even though Pluto is an Olympian god, he doesn't spend any time on Mount Olympus, right? His domain is on the underworld. Now, there is with this energy of Pluto, the capacity for things to be revealed, like secrets or things that are hidden from view. And it's interesting because Patrick Watson did a big write-up on all of the Pluto conjunctions with Jupiter over the years and found that they correlated quite often with the discovery of things like the microscope, the telescope, the ability to see that something that was invisible before, so to reveal or to blow up something, right? And you can say another way people say it sometimes is Pluto is a planet that makes the big things small and the small things big. So we're trying to get a vaccine, or there's hope for a vaccine for the pandemic, for COVID-19 or the coronavirus. And, you know, that kind of thing, like vaccine development, right? Trying to take something small, viral material, cultivated into a vaccination, Jupiter would bring that thing, by the way, and blow it up and make it available to everyone. So just the November 12th is the conjunction, right? It was April 4th, June 30th, and now November 12th, these three passes of the two coming together in the sign of Capricorn. There was an announcement today. I'm recording this on November 9th that Pfizer has come up with what looks like a viable vaccine, but it won't be ready for a year. So there, more of those kinds of reveals could happen. I don't know. I would really like something to do with UFOs or space or some space revelation. That would really be exciting. That could happen sometime around this week as well. Now, like a telescope discovery. Now, the conjunction of the two planets in your sign, ideally your rising sign, using whole sign house systems, will give you this goodness, this bounty, this benefit in one place in your chart. Now, I'll give you an example of what's happening in my life to share before I do all signs. I'm an Aquarius rising, so this conjunction of kings is occurring in my 11th whole sign house. So I have had incredible bounty appearing, prosperity, is a wealth yoga. In my friendships, in my larger social circles, I've been asked to be on a lot of people's podcasts and shows and be a part of something that's bigger than me, to be collaborative, to join someone else's group, you know, to enter into a collaborative effort with larger groups of people. One of my dear friends is Daniela Hess, and she is the founder, co-founder of Yoga Farm. And I have so many clients that I've received through being a part of the Yoga Farm community and sharing my discount code with them and everything. And that is just so 11th house, Pluto, Jupiter. And so I'm, and I actually had my birthday April 4th, the day that Pluto, Jupiter came together in the sky. And that's my solar return chart. So this wealth yoga is really baked into my year, really baked in all the way through to April of next year. So let's go ahead and talk about the all signs. Go to astro.com. If you know your birth data, please put it in there, because you'll have your exact ascendant, and that's your rising sign. You'll see that in the chart as the sign on the eastern horizon. And that's more accurate. Then secondly, you look for your sun sign if you were born when the sun was up, and your moon sign if you're born in the dark of the night. How to tell when you cast that chart, free chart at astro.com, is the sun below or above the ascendant descendant axis by degree? And if it's above the horizon, you're technically a day baby. And if it's below, you're a night baby. So the moon is your sect light, or the more powerful part of the story if you're a night child, like I am. My moon is in Aries with my sun, so it really doesn't matter. All right, so let's get going. Oh, and let me just say one more thing. I just looked at the Sabian symbol from my lovely Sabian symbol book here. It's called A Screen of Prophecy. And I've had this book for so long that the cover is gone. And the Sabian symbol, there's 360 symbols, one for each degree of the zodiac, for 23 Capricorn is what I'm going to read, all right? It is 22 degrees and 51 minutes, but with Sabian symbols, you round up. So 23 Capricorn, two awards for bravery in war, keyword recognition. The theme is good conduct, and it really talks about the heroic. And keywords are heroism, courage, appreciation, tribute, applause, acknowledgement, commendation, recognition, character, honor. So that's quite good. Actually, the world could use a little bit of those, don't you think? I do. I'm like, okay, let's bring it on. Bring it on. So it has a nice, noble, heroic quality to it. It's funny that it's about two awards for bravery in war, because Mars is sitting in Aries right now, retrograde, but going to go direct this week on November the 14th, 15th. And so I do hope there's no declaration of war. Venus in Libra is opposing Mars in Aries as I record this November 9th. And the last time they opposed each other in their home signs of Libra and Aries was 1941. And Pearl Harbor happened within a month or so of that conjunction. So it's an intense week. I'm just going to say, I just heard today that Donald Trump fired his Secretary of Defense and hired someone new. I hope that's not foreboding about some conflict that's going to be escalated kind of right now. I hope not anyway. So let's go ahead and do all signs. Let's talk about Aries. This is happening in your natal 10th house. Yay! It's about your career. It's basically about your status, your reputation, the action you take in the world to be seen as successful and to feel successful. It's kind of like your public stature as well. You know, things like promotions, new jobs could be possible, or rising to a new level of power in the work that you're doing, wherever that is. Even if it's your own work and you're an independent business person, you'll have greater stature, greater power in the field of your work right now. And it may be very specific. I mean, this yoga could bring you something this week around an opportunity, being invited to do something or being invited to participate or being given a recognition or something like that. So I was given them an Aries sun and moon. I'm hoping for that. That'd be really great. Yeah. And go back to April 4th, everyone. Remember that. And June 30th, and see if you can connect some dots about themes of success and career. All right, Taurus, this is your ninth house where the two of Pluto and Jupiter join together, and reminding you to look back again, April 4th, June 30th, and now the last pass. Now, this is a part of your house, your chart, Taurians, that has to do with your education. If you're at college or university, or you're a professor, or anything to do with higher education, this is the zone of the chart. So you could be having some wealth there, some bounty, some goodness, some experience of something positive. And It also is the house of book publishing. If you published a book or thinking of publishing a book, you could have success in that endeavor. It's a higher spiritual philosophy. It also can be about courts. So if you have anything you're doing legally and you're feeling anxious about it, this could be a real breakthrough, and something very positive could come from anything to do with law, legal, courts, justice. You could also find that if you have a spiritual teacher, something very powerful happens with that teacher. And if you don't, you could find a very powerful spiritual teacher, because this is guides, mentors, and shamans and gurus up there in the ninth house. And, you know, don't forget that these are all possible. It's not an either or story. You know, any of them. Foreign lands, especially travel to foreign lands, can be ninth house. However, with COVID, that may not be possible for you. But nonetheless, for you Taurus, Sun, Moon, and Ascendant, you could be traveling as a result of the wealth yoga. But it wouldn't be domestic travel. It would be to a foreign country. And that would be a very positive trip. And maybe you traveled on April 4th, maybe you traveled around June 30th. Don't forget, these are all happening in the same place. It's one big story, one big area of your chart that's being blessed with this wealth yoga. Gemini, this is happening in your natal eighth house. And in your eighth house, it's a very hidden house. It's kind of, you know, a darker place. It's the house of the underworld. Pluto quite likes it there. I'm in the underworld house and I'm the god of the underworld. I mean, there are underworld type houses in the zodiac, right? And the 4, 8, 12. The moksha liberation houses can be very much like the spiritually deep houses. And so with the combination of the two of them coming together, Gemini, Sun, Moon, and Ascendants in your eighth house, this is a wealth house as well. It is a house where you can leverage other people's money, like a bank loan, your husband or partner or spouse's money, your wife's money, money that comes from stipends or grants or unexpected sources, windfalls sometimes, but it's usually money that belongs to someone else. Sometimes your investment money or money from selling a possession, like a real estate, can be delineated as eighth house, as well as business partnership monies. So, because your business partner shares the money, right? Other person's money. So I would say to you, this could be a wealth yoga in a wealth house, Gemini, Sun, Moon, and Ascendant. You might just have ka-ching, ka-ching, some really good wealth news coming for you around the 12th of this month. And as I said earlier, always pay attention to the degree for anyone who has planets that are close to the 23 degree of Capricorn or the cardinal signs. It's going to be Aries, Libra, Cancer, Capricorn. It's going to be even more intense. Let's go for Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Ascendant. This is happening in the house of your relationships, your seventh house. It's a marriage house. It's long-term committed energies of relationship. It's also friendships. If you've had a friend for a long, long time, you know what I mean? And they're like, almost like you're married. That I find those kinds of friendships are delineated by the seventh house. Business partners can be seventh house as well as your clients. If you see clients because you're like me, those are seventh house people for you. Oh, look at my arm. It's going in and out of reality. So funny. I'm in my bed, guys. I'm having an in-bed day, which is why I'm using this instead of my big mic. So Cancer, Sun, Moon, and Ascendant. This could be a blessing in your marriage zone, right? And it's been trying to be, your marriage zone has been trying to be blessed for the entire year. A wealth yoga, a bounty yoga in the marriage zone. So it's about taking your existing relationship, if you have one, and bringing it to a new level. If you're a single Cancer, Sun, Moon, or Ascendant, there is a promise of a relationship that this could bring, a bounty around love and committed relationship. It would be a very powerful person, you know, and maybe a very wealthy person as well, because of Pluto, that you could get involved with. Leo, this is a six house vibration for you. It's happening in the house of your work routines, your daily habits, the house of sickness, therefore the daily habits to keep yourself well. And you know, that energy has been there April and June 30th and now again. So how have you been transforming your daily work routines, your daily habits, your daily life? Now, I always see this house as a house of service. It's also a house of karmic debt. Having this bountiful wealth yoga in the house of your karmic debt could also be very much a liberation and a release of a lot of karmic debt in the last year, 2020. When you get that debt paid off in the sixth house, you get to get the bounty of the 11th. What's going on in the 11th? Well, come for a reading, I'll tell you. That's your reward for paying off your sixth house debt. It's a six from the six. That's why I say that. Okay. Anything else I want to say about the sixth house for you, Leo, Sun, Moon, and Ascendants? if you're employed, like, you know, and you work in an office, or you have, or you're in the, you have colleagues at work, this could be some very good blessing or something going on in the workspace that is to do with one of your colleagues even, and it really benefits you. If you're an employer, it could have to do with your employees, but it's a bonus points on the game board in the sixth house of work. Okay. Pets belong here. And if you haven't been thinking of getting a pet, and Jupiter Pluto have been, you know, mashing up there since April, something could happen in November for you guys. This could be an inbound new pet or something going on that's really positive with an existing household pet animal. All right. I'm going to move on. I'm going to talk next about the Virgo rising sun and moon. This is happening in the fifth house of romance and children and inspiration and creativity and your muse and why you want to get out of bed in the morning. House of joy, joie de vivre. Now they've been joining there April 4th, June 30th. And again, here we go, right? November 12th, I would say that there's been an effort to bring a beautiful, bountiful love story here. If you're single, you may have really gotten involved with somebody during these 2020. That's been a very powerful Pluto, but generous and expansive Jupiter relationship for you. And it's going to take a new level of development around November 12th to continue that story. If you want to be pregnant or have children, this is a blessing here. And if you are already having children, it could be Virgo rising, sun and moon, something really good going on with one of your kids, having some great bounty or opportunity in their own lives, which always feels good. There's an expression like a mother is only as happy as her most miserable child. I'm going to tell you, I agree 100%. So, so true. So good news for your kids, basically. Anything else I want to say? It is the house of luck. I mean, the fifth house is the house of speculative luck. So if you're thinking of investing in something speculative or playing a lottery ticket or going to the casino, those speculative investments or speculation can reap reward. And this is the last time you get like a god of luck, Jupiter, and a house of luck joining with the god of riches, Pluto. So I'm going to say, Virgo, sun, moon, and ascendants, I would say it's a good time to, for what the heck, play the lottery this week. Just $2, $4, right? Have a spirit of adventure. See what happens. Libra, this is your fourth house of home and real estate, family of origin. Your parents, maybe particularly your mother, depending which system I use it in, where there's some kind of goodness, bounty, and wealth showing up, some abundance, some prosperity. Libra, if you own a home and you're trying to sell it or thinking of selling it, this could be very auspicious, or, you know, maybe an offer you have on a place will go through. It's just about bounty. And this has been going on since April, right? April 4th, June 30th, and the last pass. So it's bounty around real estate, home, where you live, and family of origin. So, you know, your parents basically. And so all of this is really a strong, long thread for you, Libra rising sun and moon, to really be bountiful with the land you stand on. You know, the fourth house is a place where you find gold and silver and cryptocurrency, because you mine crypto, right? And you know, you mine things from the fourth house. It's under the surface. So what the heck, you know, if you bought crypto, it could be really a good time for you, or you might, you know, just find it's a good time to invest in silver or gold, but also real estate. And don't do anything because I said so. I'm not your financial advisor, right? I'm just giving you an idea. Alrighty, let's go ahead to Scorpio's sun, moon, and ascendants, especially ascendant. My sun is in Scorpio rising. Oh, they are so intense. Still waters, they run very deep. And for you guys, this is happening in your third house of short trips and travel. Self-expression, writing, speaking, teaching. It's a very busy, cadent house. It's where you get like a lot of things done. It's a house of skills. I don't know if you've been learning a new skill in the last year, like April 4th, June 30th, and now. But that would be a good thing because it's Pluto Jupiter. It's a house of siblings. So good blessings in the house of your siblings as well. And derivatively, and this can be about your local friends. I find the third house is the crew, you know, like come over, I'm in my pajamas, let's watch a movie. That's been my experience of that house. I've listened to other astrologers. I think Austin Kopic once suggested that as well on the astrology podcast a year ago. And I found the same thing with my clients and their charts. So you know, I just had a friend pass away, and Mars has been going through my third house of siblings. And I was really nervous because he's doing that 6 month transit through my house of siblings. And it turned out to be a friend who's like a sister. I mean, she is like a sister, and she passed suddenly in September. And so, but this is a good thing for you guys. Okay. Sorry to be so dark. So for you, Scorpio risings and sun and moon, this is a bounty in the third house. This is goodness in the third house. Now, if you sell things, marketing, merchandising, and all of that, that can be very much a third house activity. If you're a salesperson, for instance, it's going to be a killer month of November for you. You're going to succeed. You've had some light there before, right? April and June as well, or June, July. All right. Moving forward, Sagittarius, look for that bounty in your second house of earned income and money and possessions. I mean, yeah, you got to hustle for it when it's second house. It doesn't just land on your doorstep. It's by effort. It's by your energy. It's by your self-possession, self-worth, values, stuff that belong to the second house. It's the house of your throat, your voice. What comes in, what goes out. You may have had to revise your food style with Jupiter, Pluto combining there three times over the last year. But also, if you have a message and you want to speak something into the world, it is about the voice, you know? So like the third house, the self-expression is the hands, but the second house is the throat. If you are looking for new ways to earn money and have bounty in your earnings and revenue, this is definitely a good time. And if you could come into possession of something that is very valuable this November 12th, give or take a week around that. So pay attention to possessions that could be quite lucrative or valuable and give you some good financial gain. Oh, you could sell a possession. Like, yeah, oh my God, I had that painting in my wall for years. I didn't know that it was worth $1 million. Let me sell it. That kind of thing. Capricorn. And this is happening in your first house of identity, your body. This is good for your body. This is good for you. I'm having a hot flash. It's really hot in Montreal, guys. Like, oh, I got the window open to my bedroom door, but I'm so hot now. So, sorry, back to the first house, Capricorn. You have any planets, Capricorn, or your ascendant at 23 degrees, give or take 3 degrees, 20 to 26 degrees. It's very much a powerful wealth yoga for you this year. Your whole identity brings you bounty, goodness, and prosperity. You being you, you just being you, Capricorns. It's all good. This is where the bounty is, the expression of your avatar. The character that you're playing in this life is where the bounty is. And it could be very, just very good for your health because it's your body. And like, you know, Jupiter is trying to bring blessings to the physical body. Oh, you could put weight on with Jupiter there in the last year. Okay, I'm not going to pretend. And Pluto would be to find things that are hidden, but in a lucky way. Like, oh my God, I just went for some routine blood work and they found X, Y, Z and they caught it so early. It's no big deal. You know what I mean? That kind of thing. So you'll have some lucky breaks with your health that way, a bounty around the body and personality. Okay. Aquarius, I am Aquarius rising, sun, moon, and ascendants. I have this Aquarius rising thing, man, that I'm so excited about this next thing that happens, conjunction of kings coming up on December 21st, so, but I digress. So Aquarius rising, the third of the wealth yogas is in the 12th house. Remember it was April 4th. It was April 4th. It was baked into my 11th house, by the way, by the solar return. So I should be clear that it's, but it's happening for me as an Aquarius rising, like it is for all you Aquarius rising sun and moons. It's happening in the 12th house of the hidden realms of your dreams at night, of your inner world, of your past lives. It's not a very overt house. It's very subtle. I will say that I have had some amazing, incredibly powerful dreams, game-changing dreams in that 12th house. It can be foreign lands as well, or revenue even, like the spice trade stuff, income coming from afar, from foreign lands, which I've had because my business has done really well this year and my clients are all over the place and they're mostly not Canadian, so foreign lands. So bounty from foreign lands has been true for me. Made a lot of successful money this year as an astrologer, and also teaching another course of mine by being able to work with people around the world. I also would say that you guys, Aquarians, might look at the karmic piece. You know, it's a past life energy in that 12th house. So some of your bounty this year is like the treasure from another life being brought forward. Like, some of your good karmic merit. Oh yeah, this is really cool. Some of your good karmic merit coming forward and playing itself out this year. And so April 4th, July, end of June into July. And here we go again, November 12th. If enlightenment is something that you're into, like awakening, spiritual awakening, this is a liberation moksha house where liberation and spiritual awakening can happen. So you could have a real boom, a really powerful spiritual awakening, especially with Jupiter meeting guru, dispeller of darkness as well, with Pluto power. November 12th, you could encounter a spiritual teacher if you don't have one and you're looking for one, or one you have maybe more present in your life, and it could bring some spiritual luminosity to your story. Last and never least, Pisces rising, sun and moon, the joint combination of the two babies coming together in your 11th house, Jupiter and the two brothers, Jupiter and Pluto. This is the bounty that comes to you from social networks, belonging to larger groups, a collaboration. It's a house of your hopes, dreams, and wishes. And if you can lean into your hopes, dreams, and wishes and just go for it, love it. I'm on my pillows and just go for it. You're going to find that your hopes, dreams, and wishes are very bountiful and very prosperous. Like, you should be following your true goals. You should be leaning into them because you'll succeed. You know, the 11th house is great gains monetarily from the career you pursue in the 10th. So, and rewards and notables, you know, like getting, like an Academy Award would be an 11th house event. So I think that you can look at this as your stature in your career going up this year as well, but it gets even better around November 12th. And you're going to start to see even more prosperity from your career, but also from being collaborative, working with other people, being a part of something larger than yourself. All right, guys, check my description box below if you want to check out my readings and what's going on. I have a Patreon community. You're welcome to join. The cheapest is $5 a month. I've started something new. It's called the Astro-Tarot Tuesdays with my sister Cindy, who's a Lenormand tarot reader. And every Tuesday night from about 8 o'clock to 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, we're going to do a commentary on some current event. And then we're going to take question and answers for live readings using the tarot, the Lenormand Tarot and astrology, maybe even horary. So if that interests you at all, check that out with me. I'm going to make it a part of my Patreon tier. So you'd have to get onto my Patreon account to be a part of that. But just think about it. It could be a lot of fun for you. $5 a month and you get these Tuesday night events you can come to. The recordings will be put up on my YouTube channel, not the part where we take Q&A, the part where the first 20 minutes where we talk about a future event, or we try to predict a future event. So this Tuesday, November the 10th, my sister and I are talking about, will the Democrats take the US Senate with the two runoff elections in January? So stay tuned for that. Again, if you want to get on that call or be a part of that, just go look at my Patreon account and sign up for the first tier. All right, ciao, ciao.